So kick it off, take it away, and action.
All right. Hello, everyone. I'm Manish Mehrotra. I'm the Director of Digital Business and Connected Car. With me, CJ Ekman, the rock star on my team, who's helped develop the digital piece. So what we're going to show you today is, it's about a 5 to 7 minute demonstration, is how does the digital key actually work? And we are also going to show you the demo of the remote smart parking assist. And we'll do a lot more of this during lunch, but at least you get to understand what these features are. You've heard a lot about digital key in the presentation today, but the basis is, phone is becoming very critical to what we do, right? So what we have thought at Hyundai is, while luxury car makers have done this, we have brought this to the mass market car, we're the first. And what we have also done is integrated this to your profiles. So when you're using phone as key, it's gonna remember your presets, your audio, your seats and mirrors. So that's really a cool feature. And we're very proud to do this for this beautiful Sonata. So without further ado, I'll turn it over to Mr. CJ. And then we're going to be around. We're going to be driving with some of you. If you have questions, if you want to get into more details, we can talk a lot more about both BlueLink features as well as digital key.
Thanks, Manish. Hello, everybody. So I wanted to just do a quick demo of the feature and kind of talk about some of the interesting things that we did with Hyundai Digital Key. And then I'm also going to show you Remote Smart Park Assist. So with Hyundai Digital Key, essentially replaces all of the functionality of your traditional proximity key with an app. As Manish was saying, most of us are replacing everything we have with a phone. I was talking last night, I don't even have a key to my house anymore. I just use my phone to get it into my house. I'm traveling here, the dog walker comes, I can share a key. Well, with Hyundai Digital Key, you can do the same thing. So if someone needs to borrow your car, you could be anywhere in the world and send them a key and instantly they have access to the car. Say for instance, you have a kid that can't drive, maybe they're 14, 15 years old, but they always put their baseball stuff in the trunk. Normally they would have to track down the key, you have to find you have to give them key to the car. Well, with Digital Key, you can share them a key and you can even only give them access to get in and out of the car and not drive it. So if you wanted someone to be able to only get in the car and pop the trunk, you can just share access with them to only get into the car. But if you want them to drive it, you can enhance the access so they can also drive the car. And as Manish was saying, it's all tied to profiles. So when you use your phone as the key, it knows who's driving the car. So when I get in the car, it has the office as Hyundai. When my wife drives the car, it has her office. The radio presets are my radio presets. The seat goes to my seat. Even the electronic mirrors, side mirrors, they adjust based on the driver, and the heads-up display height adjusts based on the driver, all because the digital key knows who's driving the car when you place the phone on the wireless charger. So let me show you guys how it works. It's funny, whenever I do this demo, I always feel like I always say it's underwhelming because it works like a key, but that's exactly what we want, right? It's instant. You see, like telematics maybe takes 20 seconds or so. This is using Bluetooth to connect to the car. So if I want to unlock it, I hit unlock, and the car instantly unlocks. If I want to lock it, it instantly locks. So it really is just as quick as your proximity key. And you can even start the car. So to start it, you just hit lock, and within 4 seconds, hit start, and the car will start. And so the reason we do the 4 second is so, you can butt dial someone. We don't want people to accidentally butt start the car. So that's why we do the two. Yeah. And then if you want to stop the car, you have the ability to just turn the car off all using the app. So with that, I'm going to show you guys just quickly Remote Smart Park Assist. I really like this feature. Living in Southern California, if you've ever been to a house in Irvine, you've seen how small the garages are. So especially in places like in California where we don't have basements, our basements are our garages, so we load them full of things. And even in my house, when I get home, I have to do the shimmy. And I always look at my wife and I say, if I put on any more weight, we are not parking in the garage anymore because I can't slide in. But with this, when you pull up to your house, you can start the car. Again, with that 4 seconds lock to start. So when you use this later today, remember that. You lock it, and within 4 seconds, you start the car. And then on the key fob, there's a little arrows that will pull the car forward and backwards. I'm gonna aim the car over at Jim, I think. And we'll see to make sure that the sensors still work. But you just push forward, and so the car just went into gear, and now it'll pull forward. It uses the ultrasonic sensors on the front of the car to make sure it won't hit anything. so like Miles can walk in front of the car. I'm still pressing the button, but it stopped because Miles walked in front. And then you can also put the car in reverse as well. So now the car just went in reverse. If you look inside, you can see the cameras are on, and you can pull the car back. If I walk more than 10 feet away, the car will stop as well, just to make sure that you're close enough to the vehicle so that you can actually see the car. So if you're more than 10 feet away, it won't work. You have to be within 10 feet, which is why we call it like walking the dog. You're really, really close to the car.